time to talk baseball. Weekly update with head coach Rob Bishop and a successful weekend at home. 2 out of 3 against Western Illinois and had to work for those wins. But pitching was really the story for your team in this 3-game series.
Yeah, I thought we pitched well all weekend. Split on the doubleheader day and really pitched well enough to win both of those games, I thought. Our offense was, to me, we were just a little bit inconsistent that first day. Some of it was Warkentin and Fox for Western pitched really well, too. So it was just a well-pitched day on both sides, and they got the better of us in the second game, and we got the better in the first game. And then on Sunday, Owen pitched really well, and our bullpen pitched really well, and the bats came alive a little bit.
Not to discount the starting pitching, but you mentioned the bullpen. Had 5 different guys throw out of the pen during the 3-game series. 7 innings out of the pen, you allowed 1 earned run.
Yeah, those guys have been trending upward. And really, regardless of the name on the back of the jersey, they've all done a really good job. Ryan Barrasso's been really solid for us, and he pitched really well. Reese Arbogast, freshman, pitched really well. Alex Clemens jumped in there and contributed. And so, like, every guy that we've called on out of the bullpen has really done a good job in the last several weeks. And I think a lot of that has just been being really aggressive and throwing strikes. So we just haven't been giving away the free bases on the mound. And it's made all the difference, just with the other team's ability to score runs.
2 tight games Saturday and Sunday. If you only look at the final score, you don't realize how tight that game was into the latter stages. And then Jamie Berg hits his first career home run, and that kind of blew the doors open, and everybody relaxed at that point. Berg's somebody that, when healthy, is very dangerous, but he's struggled to be healthy. But my goodness, what a swing he put on that ball in the sixth.
Yeah, and it was, you and I talked about this yesterday. It wasn't just the swing. It was the timing of it. I mean, it's a 1-to-1 game, and honestly, offensively, we just kind of felt like we couldn't get going. I mean, we had a few 2-out rallies where you have 2 out, nobody on, and then you get a couple base runners, and it's just really difficult to score consistently that way. So Jamie's swing was big, and I just think hitting's a little bit contagious. We found a whole bunch of barrels after that point, hit a few balls out of the park, and just relaxed and got to have a little bit of fun that last few innings.
I don't know if we give enough love to Luke Ira. We really should, for everything he means to your program. He's hit safely now in 9 in a row, had the big home run in the first inning of Game 1 on Saturday to kind of get the ball rolling. Defensively, if he's not the best shortstop in the league, he's right there. He means a lot to your team.
Yeah, I mean, Luke does a little bit of everything in addition to, obviously the people that see and work with Luke every single day. I mean, he's just a great guy, does a great job in the classroom. He's a team guy. Always has a smile on his face and good energy, and whether he's having a great day or not having a great day, it'd be really difficult to tell that, by watching how he carries himself on the field. I mean, he can run, he hits for power, he has the ability. I mean, he made 4 or 5 really good defensive plays this weekend. He has the ability to make that edge play, which is an improvement over where he was as a young player. He was really good on the routine, and now he's just made himself a lot better player in general, and he's shown a lot of power and just been an offensive guy for us this year.
Fortunately, Mother Nature again not cooperating. You were supposed to play Northwestern of Iowa today. That won't happen. Why is it so important to get those games in specifically for your pitchers?
Well, I think the getting that next group of guys, whether it's your 4th starter and those bullpen guys that maybe aren't getting work every weekend, just in the game. It's really difficult in practice to replicate just the energy and the emotion of a game day. So the midweeks are really important. And then you look at the position guys. We have a lot of guys that are playing off the bench or aren't getting regular starts, and those guys for those guys to get 3 or 4 plate appearances is really important. So it's a it's a bummer. We just haven't had great luck at midweek, and no one in the Midwest has this spring getting those games in.
All right, new kids on the block. The opposition this week, Northern Colorado, fresh faces to the Summit League. So you'll head out to the Rocky Mountains, to Greeley, and take them on. Your initial impressions on the Bears?
Well, they, you know, when you look at them, honestly, they remind me of us a little bit in the preseason. They've had some weekends where they've scored 35 runs in a three-game series, and then they've had some weekends where they've struggled a little bit. At their place, like the team, all the teams in the Summit League, at their place, they're a different team. They're definitely built to play, you know, in the elevation where the ball really carries and lots of runs are scored. They swept Western Illinois at their place, and Western's a scrappy team. So I expect to have our hands full. It'll be a different kind of game, really big park, and the ball carries, and it looks like we're going to have decent weather. So, you know, you go into it thinking that it's probably going to be an offensive series, and, you know, just kind of adjust from there.